Hair loss can be overwhelming, but here's the truth, it's not a dead end. Male pattern baldness, also known as androgenic alopecia, is the most common form of hair loss in men. But advances in science and technology have really given us solutions that actually work. So in today's video, I'm going to share with you 7 of my top tips to help stop hair loss and also to help you regrow hair as well. So let's begin. So let's dive straight into tip number 1, acting early, okay? With hair loss, it's all about acting early because if the hair follicle starts miniaturizing, okay, so it gets smaller, it shrinks because of DHT, which I'm going to speak about later on. But once DHT starts doing its work on that hair follicle and we get miniaturization, it can be very hard to revive that hair follicle again. So it's really important with hair loss that you act early, okay? If you're starting to see hair loss, if you're starting to see more hair in the shower, when you're brushing your hair, all this kind of stuff, of course, always speak to your medical provider as well, but you need to act early, and that's the most important thing. And straight on to tip number 2, let's talk about minoxidil. This is a topical treatment. You spray it onto your scalp on the affected area and rub it in, all right? What it does is it promotes blood flow to that area, so to the hair follicles. There's a lot of studies basically showing how well minoxidil works at basically prolonging the anagen phase, that's the growth phase of the hair follicle. This will result in thicker and denser hair, all right? So it can be very effective, but I have had patients before report to me, for example, that they didn't see any benefit in using it. They were using it for a couple of months and they saw no benefit. So I just thought I'd share this experience with you to tell you that be patient with minoxidil. Minoxidil doesn't work straight away. It can take up to 6 months for you to actually see the effects of it, right? So don't be expecting, you know, results in a couple of weeks. You've got to be patient with this sort of treatment. And that's one of the most important pro tips to remember. And straight on to tip number 3, guys, let's talk about finasteride. This is what we call a DHT blocker, all right? Finasteride should only be taken by men. It comes as a tablet form or a topical form that you can spray on. In terms of how it works, basically it blocks something called 5-alpha reductase. It's an enzyme that converts testosterone to dihydrotestosterone. Dihydrotestosterone, we basically shorten it to something called DHT. And DHT is basically what causes our hair follicles to miniaturize, which then causes male pattern baldness, all right? So finasteride can be really effective at stopping that DHT, which is basically contributing to the hair loss. Again, can take a couple of months to work, and it can be used in combination with minoxidil, all right, to basically increase how well it works for hair loss. So now you've got a bit of an understanding of how DHT works, all this DHT that we talk about in this video is going to make a lot more sense. Basically, DHT is the enemy here. It's basically causing the hair loss. It attaches to the hair follicle, causing miniaturization. So by reducing DHT, we should see improvements in hair loss. And straight on to tip number 4, it's all about sticking to your normal hair routine, okay? Don't overreact. I completely get it. If you're losing hair, if you're going for a shower, if you're brushing your hair and you're seeing hair fall and you're seeing hair on your shirt or in your hands, it can be overwhelming, it'd be scary. And I've had a few patients actually that have been like that, who actually stopped doing their normal hair care routine, okay? So they weren't having a shower every 2 days, for example. They were having a shower once a week. When they were showering, they weren't cleaning their scalp properly. They weren't brushing their hair. And all of these really affect how healthy our scalp is. At the end of the day, hair follicles have 3 phases, okay? So I can never remember the names. There's anagen, I've got it written down, catagen and telogen phases, okay, or telogen. And they all have different durations, and it's all about the growth cycle and miniaturization and the falling and all that sort of stuff. It's going to come on the screen, so give that a read. But basically, the moral is that your hair follicles have a phase, okay, that they work through. There's 3 phases. The reality is, if your hair is going to fall, it's going to fall, okay? So by not brushing it and not washing your hair, it's going to make 0 difference, okay, in terms of that hair follicle falling or not, all right? That was the destiny for that hair follicle, it's going to happen. But the importance is that you keep your scalp healthy, and by keeping a healthy scalp through maintaining your routine and washing your scalp and brushing your hair and doing all these things, it's actually going to be really helpful for our hair to grow and also for our scalp to be healthy to help our hair follicles grow. So that's really important, and I know it's overwhelming, but I really hope that was some useful information for you. Straight on to tip number 5, I guess the next question is, what shampoo is good to use, all right? There's quite a lot of studies on the shampoo with an ingredient called ketoconazole. This is technically an antifungal shampoo, but it can be really helpful with patients who are suffering hair loss. The way that it works basically is going to give us a better scalp environment. That means that the hair follicle is going to find it easier to grow and stay there because it's reducing the inflammation by its antifungal properties. But it also blocks DHT to some extent, and DHT we spoke about that you now know all about, which again is going to help with hair loss. So ketoconazole shampoo has been shown to be quite effective for patients suffering with hair loss. And straight on to tip number six, let's talk about low level laser therapy. Okay, you might have seen those LED helmets or the wands. This basically works through a process called photobiomodulation, where basically the hair follicle absorbs the energy and it helps with the growth phase of the hair. It helps reduce shedding to some extent, but the main thing is that we're helping the growth phase, and basically it's going to help give us thicker and denser looking hair. All right, these can be quite helpful. Make sure you get an FDA approved device, okay, if you want to use them. There's usually two types of devices in the market. There's the helmet and the wand. I generally always recommend my patients to get the helmet. I just think it's far easier to use and it gets a far more even spread compared to the wand, which you have to work through the hair. Okay, the beauty of the helmet as well is you can just do normal activities with the helmet on. It's usually like 10 minutes a day or something like that, depending on the device, but it can be really helpful and there is evidence supporting them as well. Straight on to tip number seven, let's talk about hair transplants. This is for more advanced hair loss and it can offer a more permanent solution. I have seen many a patient and friends and family actually who I know have had hair transplants and have found it very effective. The way that it works is quite simple. The best way I like to explain it is if you ever look at most males with male pattern baldness, it's usually on the top and the sides of your hair and the back. You have what we call DHT resistant hair follicles, okay? These hair follicles are resistant to that DHT and miniaturization. So with a hair transplant, there's three phases. And I can never remember the name of the first one. It's FUE, which is follicular unit extraction. And basically, they harvest the hair follicles. And different clinics do it differently, but they do it in a natural way, so it doesn't really show that they harvested them. And this can be thousands of hair follicles. So these are DHT-resistant hair follicles. They implant them into the scalp, okay, in the right angle, in the right position, just so it looks natural, really. And then after that, we have the healing and growth phase, okay? I had to look up that because I can never remember the three of them. And that usually takes about 3 to 6 months. You get blood circulation happening. Sometimes you get a little bit of hair fall to begin with, which is quite normal. And once it finds its place and it can go into its growth phase, the hair follicle, you know, after 3 to 6 months, that's when we get the hair growth, okay? And because it's DHT resistant hair follicles, it's gonna be resisting that DHT over time, so it shouldn't fall. So next up, let me tell you about Smile Hair Clinic. They specialize in hair transplants and they're based in Istanbul, Turkey. And they have a trademarked approach to hair transplants called the Smile True philosophy, which is all about three main elements. So we start with true planning, where they analyze your donor area in detail and create a personalized plan. Next, we have true hairline design, which prioritizes natural aesthetics and hairline proportions. And lastly, true execution on the day of your procedure. Their packages include a 5-star hotel stay, post-operative care for 12 months, and procedures performed by experienced doctors who actually founded the clinic. And to learn more about Smile Hair Clinic and their services, definitely do click the link in the description below. Oh, and by the way, you can also use it to book a free consultation to get more information. Smile Hair Clinic, thank you for being our trusted sponsor. So this video has already become quite long, but I just want to thank you for watching this video. There's loads of videos out there and you chose to watch my video, and I really hope these tips were helpful, okay? Hair loss can be overwhelming, it can be scary, it can be worrying, and I really hope that these tips and information was something new that you learned that you didn't know about. The most important thing about hair loss is if you are ever experiencing hair loss and it's abnormal for you, to speak to your medical provider so they can examine you, do the test, and make sure there's nothing else that's contributing to it as well. I will leave loads more information in the description below. And if you know anyone this video would help or they'd find helpful, feel free to share it to them as well. And as I always say, sending awesome vibes, and I'll see you next week. DHT, DHT, H. Honestly, today's one of those words where my mouth is just not working properly. DHT. Is it DHT or DHT? Oh, film it. How you do? This is a comment that I get quite often, actually. People picking on me because I say H. And I know the right way is H,
But that's just how I sing H.
But I've reached a stage where I'm just talking to myself now.